Okay, so we are starting our weapon. At the beginning, I want to tell you that video mostly is speed up and we skip some less interesting parts just to save you time and just to cover the most interesting and important parts of this process. The audio is recorded right after the video, so I will be commenting stuff that are going on the screen. So you can see I've collected a bunch of images of this weapon, and some of these that are very high res we will use as a reference in Maya to make our weapon. You can see right now that I am putting the reference image on the place, and I tend to put the reference image on the separate layer, and just because I want to make it unselectable, so this way I will not select it when I don't need it. So the main shape of this weapon is very simple. Right now you can see I'm using this instance icon just to make the other side of the weapon . And you can see I always bring some reference to the screen because I currently didn't have a second monitor for my references. So you can see I forget to create a new project at the beginning, so I'm doing it right now. And of course we have to save our scene, and we can use increment saves to save our scene as a copy. So you can see I was showing you some references that I was using to make this weapon. Right now we will be making these holes in this part of the weapon. It is a little bit tricky. So I will show you the process of making few of these holes, and then we will just skip. So you can see there is not a lot of stuff to comment at this part of this tutorial. You can see a very basic and simple poly modeling. I'm just using the tools that I've explained in the previous part, in the previous video. So you can see I've applied a Phong material, and it's very important sometimes to use material with some kind of specular, because it shows you better the surface of the model. You can see a little bit clearer if there is some kind of distortion on the surface or some kind of bug. So it's really better to use this kind of materials with specular while modeling. So you can see we will use the same technique for this upper hole. We will just extrude this part. So you can see while using subdivision surface, we've got bunch of distortions around this hole, so we have to put more geometry around this place, and I'm doing it right now using just split polygon tool to prevent this geometry to create just these weird bugs.